My reflections this week are inspirational stories about persons who overcame obstacles and made a significant contribution to the American culture and landscape. Recently, it was the birthday of the man who wrote the lines, "The night is young, the skies are clear, so if you want to go walking, dear, it's delightful, it's delicious, it's lovely. I understand the reason why you're sentimental, 'cause so am I. It's delightful, it's delicious, it's lovely. You can tell at a glance what a swell night this is for romance. You can hear, dear, Mother Nature murmuring low, let yourself go. So please be sweet, my chickadee, and when I kiss you, just say to me, it's delightful, it's delicious, it's delectable, it's delirious, it's dilemma, it's delimit, it's deluxe, it's lovely." Cole Porter was born in Peru, Indiana in 1891. His musical education, one of the most extensive ever received by an American theater composer, began under his mother's tutelage with the study of piano and violin. He went to Yale University, where he got horrible grades, but wrote and performed more than 300 songs for school shows. Although his Yale triumphs had earmarked him for almost certain success in the theater, his Broadway debut as a composer and co-lyricist of the comic opera See America First in March of 1916 was a fiasco and ran for only 15 performances. In June of 1917, Porter headed off to Europe, worked for a relief organization, enlisted with the French Foreign Legion, and eventually settled in Paris. He was working at the American Embassy, where on January 30th, 1918, he met the exquisite Linda Lee Thomas, who someone described as a great beauty with great brains. She and Cole fell in love and were married in Paris in December of 1919. For a substantial portion of the 1920s, the Porters made Europe their home, especially Paris and Venice. They traveled widely and lived and entertained on a grand scale. Linda widened Cole's artistic horizons by introducing him to many outstanding cultural figures, as well as leading members of the International Café Society. Yet the 1920s were filled with immense professional frustration for Porter, as he was thought to be little more than a playboy expatriate and succeeded in placing only a few songs in stage reviews both in London and New York. Nevertheless, supported by the constant encouragement of his wife, Porter continued to work. It is no secret that the songs that appear to listeners to have been tossed off with the most casual effort are in fact the product of a lifelong dedication to his profession and nights and days of arduous labor. Porter worked away from his piano, writing words and music almost simultaneously. He would begin by writing the opening and end of the song first. Then he would proceed from the beginning and ending towards the middle. The results often produce songs with a special artistic unity, fresh, and free of many of the clichés of the vast preponderance of songs of that age. In 1928, and sung by the international favorite Irene Bordoni, Porter wrote his first big hit, "Let's Do It, Let's Fall in Love," which begins, "Birds do it, bees do it, even educated fleas do it. Let's do it, let's fall in love." The rest, as they say, is theatrical history, as Let's Do It was an instant smash, and from then on, Porter's reputation was firmly established in the front ranks of the theater. Cole Porter's career was totally unlike that of the Gershwins, Rodgers and Hart, and countless others, for he did not come from the ranks of Tin Pan Alley, song plugger, rehearsal pianist, vaudeville accompanist, and the like. Porter, on speaking of his success, referred to it as a night-blooming flower. It was slow in coming, but it did nevertheless. His shows like The New Yorkers, Anything Goes, Gay Divorce, Dewberry Was a Lady, and countless others boasted numerous hit songs that buoyed the nation's spirit during the Depression. Porter suffered a horrific riding accident in October of 1937, which required over 30 operations and kept him in constant pain the remainder of his life. Yet he kept on composing, creating some of the most memorable shows of all time: Out of This World, Can Can, Silk Stockings, and the movie High Society with Bing Crosby, Grace Kelly, Frank Sinatra, and the incomparable Louis Armstrong. Cole Porter died on October 15, 1964. In our own day, the music and lyrics of this gifted and talented man can lift the spirits of this nation as we journey through crisis, health concerns, and the beginning of a recession. In 1934, Cole Porter himself recorded the title song of his hit musical, Anything Goes. He noted the strange happenings of a topsy-turvy world.
In olden days, a glimpse of stocking was a look dawned of something shocking, but now God knows anything goes. Good offers to who once knew better words, now only used for letter words, writing prose. Anything goes. If driving fast cars you like, if low bars you like, if old hymns you like, if fair limbs you like, if Mae West you like, or me undressed you like, why nobody will oppose. When every night the set that smart is intruding and nudist parties in studio, anything goes.
This American icon continues to make us cry, laugh, and inspire as he touches our hearts through the gift of music. Be safe and be well. I look forward to being with you again soon.